Back now with a fresh headache for the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, igniting a war with crossbenchers by slashing their personal staff. Independents have so far slammed the decision as a direct attack on democracy.
We are joined now by Independent MP Zali Steggall in Jindabyne. Good morning, Zali, or you probably don't think it's a very good morning at all.
Look, it's a bit difficult and it's very disappointing. It's a little bit more of the taking out the trash on a Friday afternoon when we get a letter asking us to sack 3 out of 4 of our advisers on a Friday afternoon.
What kind of impact will this have on you and the work that you can get done?
Look, it's huge because we consider each piece of legislation. We consult with stakeholders, we listen to the communities, we propose amendments, and that is all done from the benefit of having advisors to be able to do that research and do those consultations. So it's essentially not going to be possible to consider each piece of legislation. And the suggestion from the Prime Minister is that some kind of central bank of staffers in the library can do it. But the library are very clear in their role. That is not their role to advise. They can do research, but they don't understand, the intricacies of representing your community, and they certainly don't draft legislation. You have to give instructions to the drafter to get legislation drafted, and basically the Prime Minister is suggesting that we have no ability to propose alternate policy or legislation.
What you do have an ability to do, and particularly your crossbench colleagues in the Senate, is prevent legislation from passing. Have you spoken with them and will you be taking action against the PM?
Look, I have spoken to some members of the Senate crossbench, and we are actually due to have the lower house crossbench is due to have a meeting next week in Canberra, and so I anticipate we will all be discussing this. It's very incredibly short-sighted of the Prime Minister, and I think it really doesn't bode well because it's basically saying, well, I don't respect the work the crossbench has done in the last parliament or can do in this coming parliament. And I would remind the Prime Minister that most of the policy work when it's come to integrity, anti-corruption and integrity and holding the government to account and moving the government on climate change and net zero commitments has in fact come from the crossbench. And all of that work would not have been possible without advisers.
And Parliament hasn't already set and we're setting up for a feud. Zali, appreciate your time this morning. The person you did provide advice to is Anthony Albanese. He sparked anger on the crossbench, deciding to cut their staff allocations from 4 down to 1. And we spoke to Zali Steggall earlier, who's very upset about this. I mean, it's going to make your job harder in the Senate, won't it?
Well, I've been getting some feedback on this decision as well from the crossbench. This is a matter that the Prime Minister has looked at. It's a matter for the Prime Minister to make allocations of personal staff. Crossbenchers will, of course, get the 4 staff that all members of Parliament get and then an additional advisor. I would say when I was in the opposition, I had 2 personal staff allocated to me.
Can I step in there, though? But you know you had party staff as well. And everyone in the ministerial office had party staff. The leader of the opposition had party staff. So it's not just genuine to say that you had 2 staff.
Well, the opposition and the government get an allocation of staff. That's right. Yeah. I didn't have any party staff, so to speak. I mean,
no, but the advice you got came from that party staff on legislation that the crossbench do not get.
Well, yeah. I think we certainly have more of us and we can share resources across the board. But the issue is each crossbench will have 5 staff. We'll look at an increase to the parliamentary library to help resource on issues around the parliament, legislation, research, all of those things. But, you know, we're all making cuts and savings. I mean, we've made savings in the order of just over $1 million. I think it's about $1.5 million in relation to staffing our side of the chamber. Mm. And we're having to be sensible going forward. The budget's in a terrible shape and we're all having to tighten our belts.
Look, we really appreciate both your time this morning. It is something we could talk about for quite a long time, both those topics and quite intense for a Saturday morning. We appreciate it. Right.